So if you pray a lot, that means that sickness and diseases is dying in your life. Everything is going to be all right. Amen? So Paul is telling the Corinthians, is that here, look, we got to learn to stick together. Don't start criticizing and telling one another's business. Don't put one another's business all out in the street. Let's just stick together. And I'm not going to come to you with all enticing words and trying to make me look like something when I ain't nothing. Amen? Amen? Let's go. Read. Would not with what?
Enticing words.
So my speech, and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, amen? But in demonstration of what?
A spirit of what?
Because man's wisdom is when you sick. Amen. Man cannot speak a cure into your life. Amen. They might tell you what to do or try to tell you how to get rid of it. And then you say, well, I tried that. It ain't. Because you know why? Because the sickness that we had in us, there's no cure on earth for sin. Amen. You can go to the doctor. He don't necessarily cure you. He just give you something to get you by. But see, for sin, there's no doctor in the world, no matter how many years he went to college, no matter how much he studied on the human body, he cannot cure sin. Amen? God is the only one that can move through your body and put something in and take something out. So if you are a sinner, there's only one solution. And that's Jesus Christ. He's the only one that can take away your sins. Amen? When he died, he gained the power over your sins. Amen? That's why would I preach something else? Something else doesn't matter. Why would I preach what another man tell me to preach? He don't know nothing. But when I preach what God tells me to preach, God knows exactly what we need when we need at the time we need. Because he's God. He created us. He know our ins and he know our outs. Without him, we can't even function. Amen? Without him, we can't even function. Amen? Every time we do get out of line, the first thing come out of our mind, the Holy Ghost reminds us of who we are. And it lets us know that we're wrong for getting out of line. Amen? Amen? Some people say when they get ready to steal, my stomach start hurting. No, the Holy Ghost stirs stuff up in you to tell you don't do it. When I get ready to sin and do something wrong, I get scared. It's a scary feeling that comes. No, that's the Holy Ghost coming over you, telling you don't even try it. Because the results is death. It might not be physically death, but sin is a part of death. You finna commit a sin that you're gonna be sorry for. You get caught. And when you get caught, your sin has revealed you that you are a thief. Amen? But before you even make that move, there's a feeling come over you. And your stomach start hurting a little. And you be scared. See, fear is sometimes a warning. Fear ain't always bad, because what the Word of God said, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. So when fear comes over, you say, hold up, something wrong, I'm scared. But we are just like, push through it, because the flesh talks us into it. But Satan is so shasty that he'll let you get away with it all. And the one time that you just know for a fact that you're not going to get caught, the trap is set. Amen. Your credibility of a person, your trust, everything is gone. We don't want you in this store no more. Amen. Amen. Let's go read. Wait a minute. Five. That your faith should not in the wisdom of man. In other words, don't put all that you believe in a man. Amen? You should have no faith in another man or woman. That everything you need, all your belief should be in God. Amen? Put your faith in. Put your faith where? In God. Not in man. Amen? Because God loves a faithful servant. Amen? Because faith, let me tell you something. When something is going down in your life and you need some help from God, all you got to do is believe that he can do it. And if you believe that he can do it, he will. And don't doubt. But guess what makes us doubt? Circumstances, a friend, or a name. I put my trust in God, and I just need to ask you this. What do you think? Huh? I know God is with me, but I just need to know some more. Amen? Because we don't have the patience. We pray for some, say, Lord, I need you, Lord, to deliver me from this, but we always go to men. We just got to hear man's wisdom on our situation. And they don't know. And you know they don't know. Nothing. But we trust their opinion. And guess what? Once you trust their opinion, that means that God's wisdom doesn't matter. Because God said, how could you come to me, a problem solver, no matter what, and go to somebody with no power and ask them to do for you what you have already asked me to do for you. For you. Amen? It's called this. Once you put it in God's hands, leave it alone. Don't question nobody. Don't ask nobody about it. Because guess what? Satan already there listening. And it'll bug you. You ever notice that I prayed for it, but it just, someone won't let me go. I need to ask somebody else about this thing. I prayed for it, but maybe they can give me some advice. And then you start making up excuses to talk to somebody else about it when you already prayed for it. Thank you, Lord. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. That's me too. Amen. Because we're so desperate for it to be answered, we go to everyone. And they don't know. And once you go to everybody, you just open up this. Guess what? You just prayed for something, and now you're telling everybody your prayer. And the word of God said, pray in secret. Amen? You pray in secret, and I'll reward you openly. It's not a secret no more once you console somebody else about it. Amen? On the cross, if you get on your knees about something, leave it alone. Don't talk to nobody. Even if it seems like the situation is getting worse, let God work it out. Hold on. Yes, it's going to bug you. Because Satan was listening. He wants you to make another move so doubt will jump. Amen? Let's go. Read it. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of, nor of the prince of this. And who's the prince of this world? Satan is. Amen? That come today, but we speak what? That's like, okay, what's the wisdom? Who speaks the wisdom of this world?
See, rappers speak the wisdom of this world.